this part of the video is going to highlight the type of people who are childless, who I don't like. This is exactly why I don't like them. The way they talk down to parents are very condescending, arrogant. They act like they did something better by not having children. Like, good for you. I don't know. I have no words. The Black community is fucked. So I'm really not surprised that we think of all races that it's a flex to not be procreating and recreating ourselves. We can barely stay in a healthy relationship together. So yeah, whatever. We have a lot of issues. We have a lot of issues. We need a lot of therapy. It's just a lot. I'm not a psychologist, and it's just a rabbit hole. I cannot actually begin to understand, because I have children. So I don't know what it's like to be like, I hate myself, or I just hate kids, or I just feel like this weird irrational fear that we're overpopulating the world, or I have no clue. Or is it just, I just want to worry about myself and I'm selfish and I just don't want to be bothered, because some of them have said that as well. So let's go ahead and play the video so we can see. And yes, I'm including the fake ballerina as well. And then the woman behind, after her part is going to be quiet, because I guess the woman didn't want like any issues with copyright or something. But the woman after her that's going to be talking the longest, she's especially the type of childless person I cannot stand.
This is precisely why I will always judge parents. And I know a lot of parents like to say, you can't talk about having kids if you ain't parenting, if you never had. Yes, I can. Yes, I can. And yes, I will. Because y'all are messing these children up big time. I was making YouTube content and TikTok content. Like, I literally had to, I literally had to tell my own nephew, don't watch, get off my YouTube channel, get off of my TikTok, like, these phones and these tablets.
Why is she mad at her nephew for having access to her stuff? So, like I've said in the past, the same things that a parent would do that could be considered child abuse or negligence, that applies to all adults, whomever is in charge of that child at that time. So if the child is staying with his aunt, then she also is responsible for keeping him out of environments, technology, videos, internet, whatever devices that can harm him, that could be harmful to him in some way, shape, or form. She also has that responsibility. Just like when you send your kids to school, or you take your child to daycare, you're leaving your child in the care of whomever that caregiver is, or that daycare provider, or the school system. So if something were to happen to your child whilst being in their care, they are also held liable. Like, the parent would not be held responsible if the child was not even with them at that time. I don't know if people understand this. I know we want to create a world where we think we can run loose and free around children, and that children are not important enough to respect or protect, or, you know, be around in a safe manner if we're not their parent. But that's something that I don't see ever becoming a thing. I think that as long as you're bigger, you're big, and you're old, and you're an adult, you will always be responsible for your behaviors around children. So, like, if you hit someone else's kid, you could, you know, you can really do anything. You're going to be in prison. You're going to be in jail. You cannot treat people's children, however, because you don't have kids. So this is problematic to me, that she's acting like, I don't have children, so I can do all this random crazy stuff. Yeah, you can when you're not around other children. So if your nephew is at your house, the environment has to be a safe environment, whether you're at his house, he's at yours, wherever. If you're in charge of watching him, you're in charge of watching him. Okay, so it could be a babysitter, it could be an auntie, it could be a daycare, it could be a school, it could be a camp. It could be anywhere where children are left to be under someone else's care. So like I said before, and I reiterate, it is not always the parents' fault. I cannot believe in 2024, I still have to have this conversation, but here we are.
Are raising children, and guess what? They raising our adult ass too, because what? How much can we say when we're on the phone all the time, when parents are sitting on the phone all the time? You can't then turn around and tell your kids to get off their phones or get off their tablets when...
So I'm curious to wonder why someone who has no children is so concerned about what parents are doing with their children. Why do you care? I'm not in your house looking at how you're living your life and judging what you're doing with your life, whether it's carelessness, silliness, whatever you're doing with yourself. I'm not concerned. I'm minding my business. So why do people think when someone has a child or children, now they have the right to slide their way into your home and tell you what you should be doing with your child that you gave birth to, and that's your child, what you should be doing with your child? I really would love to know that, because I'm like, what is it? Because it's a child, you just feel like everyone, because actually I had an argument with this one lady. It really wasn't an argument, because I was not really gonna, I didn't care enough to take part in it, but she was childless, I'm pretty sure. And it's like she was ranting and raving and like really angry that she couldn't tell parents what to do. And it feels like white supremacy, where white people really just want to say the N-word and they don't understand why they can't say it. That's how I feel, once more oppressed by my own people, no less at this point, of them wanting so badly to get to tell parents what to do. You're not a parent. You're not this child's parent. So even if you were a parent, parents do not have to listen to you of that child. They can do what they want with their child, as long as it's not breaking a law. And last time I checked, the kid playing on a tablet all day is not a law breaking. There are so many bigger things going on in the world. I know this child right here, just something about her and kids and parents grinds her gears where she can't focus on the bigger issues. But there are, I promise you, girl, bigger things happening in this world than a child playing on a tablet. Because I know when I was growing up, like most 80s kids and 90s kids, the TV was babysitting us. The TV raised us. So I love how every generation likes to pretend like it was perfect for us when we were kids, and our parents are perfect, or it was another generation that was better and we're the worst parents ever. It's really getting effing old at this point. Like, your energy could really be used in a more constructive manner, but someone like her, I'm glad she doesn't have any children. I pray she doesn't ever have children, because she's not the nicest of people. She's a very ugly soul. Her soul is just dark. I can feel the bad energy, and I would not want her to create a copy of that. I think she's more than enough for the world. She seems miserable. I don't know much about her life. I'm never going to be following her. It's a struggle just getting through videos like this, but I feel like they need to be seen, because people probably are going to come to my channel and wonder, like, why, what do you have against childless people? Well, here you go. You asked, I'm going to deliver. This is what I have against them. And I'm going to keep sharing content that shows how ugly they act towards parents who are minding our business. So you're essentially trying to slide into our homes and tell us what we should be doing with our child. And I just love to know, what does it have to do with you? What does it have to do with you? Pray tell. Like, is my child going to burglarize your house in a few years because he was on a tablet too much? Is he going to shoot up the whole neighborhood because he was on, is it because of that tablet? Like, what is going on here? Like, what are we doing? And she literally labeled her video tablet parenting. This is the type of person I feel is what you'd call a busybody. Like, someone who's looking out the window and peeking, always looking at the neighbors, always call. It's a Karen. She really is basically like a black Karen. Like, I'm going to call the police. You were watering your grass last night. I mean, she's just a busybody. And it's like, girl, get a dog. Get a hobby. Do anything. Like, what you're doing now is never going to become a thing. Like, no one is thinking about you. There are billions of parents on the planet. Trust me, their kid will be enjoying that tablet, okay? Because it helps with the parenting. You know parenting is hard. That's why you opted out of it. So get your opt your nose out of our business while you're at it. I mean, what is your deal?
You're doing the exact same thing. Instead of raising your kids, you online in comment sections arguing with people, gossiping about celebrities. And that's okay. There's nothing inherently wrong.
Well, thanks for your permission for me to be online arguing about celebrities with people, because I am a whole grown-ass person. But thank you, I guess, for giving me permission to be a grown-ass person.
Those things, but when you choose to have children, you don't get to indulge in things us child-free people get to indulge in.
Ooh, there we go. There we go, Miss. This is what it's all about. Okay, the real nitty-gritty of it, shall I say. Like, it's that I'm better than you because I don't have kids, so I can live a more careless lifestyle. You are burdened down with children forever. And I definitely get that vibe. I was in some group, I don't know, it's always something, Reddit, who knows where I was at. And I was just minding my business, whatever. And people were like, you have children, your life is over, like, you can't do things that we can do. And I'm like, it was a Tanya TKO video, and I think I did a video on it maybe already, but I was like, you guys really, they're really sitting here acting like, or you all, sorry, working on that terminology. But I'm like, you all are really acting like babies are like babies for 18 years. Like they want us to struggle so bad. I was in another group and I'm, you know, somehow I'm always falling into these weird conversations with these childless people. Like everybody wants to tell you they're childless. And I'm like, okay, no one asked, but okay. And she was like, you're hiring people to do things, and so now they can't be with their kids and blah blah blah. I'm like, you're kidding, right? Like, you're so wanting us to struggle as parents and suffer that you're mad that I can hire a maid and order a home delivery food service or whatever I was going to do to make my life easier. It's like, oh my gosh, how dare you enjoy your life and get to have children. Not fair. Like, I have to, like, they have to feel like they're one-upping us somehow. How strange is that? Is it because you wanted kids and couldn't have them, so you're like, oh, I gotta really make this count for myself? Like, I don't get it, but I feel like there's no humility there. There's a lot of arrogance. I feel like you need to just bite the bullet. Like, whatever life deals you, then you just take it and move on. Whether you decide to adopt a child instead or get a dog or do whatever, you just take the cards you're dealt and you make the best of them. That's what parents do. That's what all mature adults do. You don't get online and try to belittle or degrade, demoralize, like trying to make other people's lives like seem like insignificant or bad in some way so you can feel better about yourself. That's pretty pathetic, actually. Like, it really is. I would be more of a person who'd want to uplift others. Like, I'm making my channel to uplift Black single mothers. And part of the reason why this channel had to be created was because of the attacks that I was seeing on Black single mothers. It was either people trying to force us into marriage, trying to say we're not, our values lowered because we have a child, or people like her saying what we can and can't do. And it's like, excuse me, who are you again? You're nobody to me. Like, I literally can just click off of TikTok and keep minding on about my day. Like, who does she think she is? That's what I would love to know. Like, you really think you have enough power to sit yourself on TikTok? You think you're going to change anybody's life? She wished she had that kind of power. That's just crazy. And it's like, why do you feel like you need that kind of power? What are you so angry about? Like, there's something there that I can't put my finger on, but it's very dark and ugly. It's very nasty attitude. And it's just like, where is this coming from? And you all are going to see some of the weirdness going on as this video continues. So it's just strange. I had to share this video because her video came on after the fake ballerina. And I was like, this is interesting. And I'm telling you now, you all, like, whenever I hear from childless people, for the most part, there's maybe a few that are like nice and normal, but like a majority of the ones I've had encounters with, they act just like her. Very ugly, nasty attitude. I can show you the comments that I was on with the other woman, or I think it was a woman the other day, and just a whole novel of nastiness. She's like all over the place. Like, oh, you just seem so arrogant. It's like she was just so mad that I told her, like, we're not going to listen to you. Like, you don't have authority over parents. Like, why do you need to have that? That's strange. That's really weird. Like, you're acting like a whole white person right now, trying to conquer black people in slavery. Like, it's just strange. Or you're acting like a man trying to conquer a woman and force her to submit. What is giving people this need to do this? And what is giving them the right? What's making them feel like they have the right to do this? Because we have a child, so you think, oh, you're vulnerable, let me pick on you. That's even more reason for me to stand my ground. Because I am in charge. I'm a whole other human being. So what I'm not going to be is flimsy. I'm not going to flip-flop about. Because if anyone needs to be standing on their square about their morals and their values and their standards and their beliefs and their boundaries, is going to be a parent.
You don't, because you have a larger responsibility that you choose.
And she's correct. And of course, she just can't wait to say that you chose. And you chose to not have children, honey. You chose to not have children. So go mind your childless business.
A lot of these parents will reap what they sow when it comes to how they're raising their children.
Why are we now reaping what we've sown? Yeah, I am going to reap what I've sown. I'm going to have children to take care of me when I'm old. I'm going to have grandkids. I'm going to enjoy my life as I go into my golden years. And I'm going to have family around me when I'm dying. I'm going to have people to leave my stuff to and just enjoy my life with my children. Yeah, I can't wait for that. I'm reaping some of it now, and it's pretty great.
Really? I mean, these poor kids, like, I don't even know what they're going to do.
What poor kids? What poor kids is she talking about? You know, American children are some of the most spoiled children in the world. One second. American children are some of the most spoiled children in this world. But now she's talking about these poor kids. Girl, go to a third world country if you're so concerned about kids and their well-being.
Saying how these five-year-old little girls in ballet, of all things, are not listening, not following instruction.
I doubt those five-year-old little girls exist. I would literally need to see them on camera to believe the fake ballerina story. But we're supposed to sit here and just cry ourselves a river that there's these five-year-old little girls out here somewhere singing Pound Town, and their whole futures are ruined because they're singing Pound Town. First of all, where are these little girls? I am going to show you a video of who is doing this, but it's not as often as people think. It's not this big gang of little five-year-olds taking over the world singing Pound Town. And I think I've said it earlier in the video, when children are that little singing a song like that, they don't even know what it means. I know I was singing some pretty sexually suggestive songs at that age. It did not do anything to my life today. So I don't know if that will help people. Maybe not her, because she wants parents to suffer for whatever reason. But I know there were songs that I was listening to. My parents were listening to them. The radio was playing them. I was enjoying them. And I loved them to this day. But I can tell you, at five, I had no clue what I was singing. So was it going to affect my life? How could it? I had no capacity to understand what the heck I was singing. My brain had literally not even fully developed. So she can breathe if she's so worried that five-year-old singing Pound Town is going to take over the world and annihilate it. Like, chill, lady. I think we're going to be good. I'm pretty sure there's people in this world a lot more evil, a lot more dangerous than five-year-olds singing Pound Town, if they even exist in a quantity that matters.
Talking about, you ain't my mama, you can't tell me what to do.
And how did those little girls supposedly, allegedly say all that when the same fake ballerina said that they did not, that they also said you can't, she was saying they couldn't even speak and say, can I go to the bathroom? So they can say, you're not my mama, you don't tell me what to do. They can say all that. They can sing Pound Town lyrics, but they don't know how to say, can I go to the bathroom? Like, one of the most basic phrases ever that you use, like, on a daily, I would think. Okay. Yeah, that really sounds believable to an actual parent of five.
crazy part is I just saw a video, like a comedy, you know, reel or whatever, about how teenagers are in like high school and the things that they say. As a kid, we've all said.
Yeah, exactly. And they're teenagers that say that. 5-year-olds don't say those things. Unless someone taught them to say it and they think it's funny and cute, a typical 5-year-old is not going to be saying, "You're not my mama. You don't tell me what to do." Like, I've never heard a 5-year-old say that. Just, I haven't. And if the parents are teaching their child to say that, then yes, they are definitely in the wrong. But I don't hear that. Usually kids are listening. They're crying at the most at 5. They're pretty little. They're usually listening to you still. That's usually something that a teenager would say, which again made her story that more unbelievable. The fake ballerina, by the way, that is who I'm talking about. That made her story more unbelievable. I'm like, I've never heard a 5-year-old talk to me like that. So that's giving, I'm not a parent, I'm lying out my ass, and I'm making up a story that in reality would not even make sense to an actual parent who has children that have actually reached adulthood. Now, I can understand parents who are like having young children. Maybe they don't know yet what kids can and can't do. But 5-year-old saying, "You're not my mama. You can't tell me what to do." Where are they at? Like, wow, okay. Like, usually children that little are going to listen when you're in a position of authority. Now, are they going to always listen to you perfectly? They might have, you know, they might cry. They may have a temper tantrum or whatever, but have I ever heard them actually say that entire phrase? But then they can't say, "Can I go to the bathroom?" That would be interesting. See, when you put stuff together, when you're in the military, there's like a certain level of, you know, clearance you sometimes can get. And they I forget what they call it, but it's like sometimes like you can have separately, the information is nothing that you might have. But when you put it all together, it's now extremely dangerous. That's how I'm looking at the fake ballerina. It's like separately her stuff could possibly make some sense. But when she puts it all together, it's like, this is a very far-fetched story. It doesn't ring true. It doesn't make sense. As a mother, I can't see all these things going together all in this one little story that she's giving with this group of children that she has no photo of, no video of. But yeah, you can go to other ballet teachers and they have plenty of video of the classes that they're teaching. Like, almost all ballet people are going to have video because people put like everything online and they record everything. And I just think it's interesting that she doesn't have like not one video of this supposed class. Is so out of control that she had to come online and get her filter together so she could be pretty, but come online and cuss parents out. Where are these kids? Where are these alleged parents that are so awful? Where are they? Why aren't they speaking out? Your video went viral. I know if that was me, I would have some words to say. I mean, I have some words to say, and a lot of parents have some words to say. And we're not even, our kids are not even in your class. So where are these parents? And you notice the fake ballerina was saying, you know, "I want some moms to stitch me." She never said, "I want those mothers to stitch me and tell me why this is going on with your children." Or, you know, "I want to hear from them and have them tell their side of the story." Like, she just said she wants to hear from some random mothers about this situation. It's like, why don't you talk to the women who you're claiming are teaching their kids Pound Town? I don't get it. Like, what do you want us to do? Yell at them? Like, this is what I mean by you're not telling other parents what to do. Parents don't even tell other parents what to do because, one, we get it. We know it's a sensitive thing. People don't want people telling them what to do about their kids, period. That's just what it is. I don't care what race, gender, what you're doing. People just don't want to hear about you. That's a very sensitive topic. And if you want people to really not like you, like, keep running around thinking, "I can tell you about what you can do with your child." Make that make sense. It's like people think because you have a child, you've lost some kind of leverage in the world, or you are now a big child yourself. I don't get it. And they use it as an excuse of like, "Oh, I'm trying to help you out," or "I'm trying to get, did I ask?" It's unsolicited. Nobody asked for it. No one needs it. No one's going to do anything with it. Mind your business.
"You ain't my mama" thing. Then there's a fine line between like at five, and at five, you're being very adamant about not listening, and then the mom proceeds to show up and just like, well, why you keep asking her to do something she don't want to do? All kids.
Well, that's an honest question. I mean, if she doesn't want to do it, then stop asking her to do it. You can't force a child to do it. Children do have some rights. I mean, I don't know. Like, maybe the mother will talk to her child herself, but maybe the child's having a bad day. I mean, I don't know. Maybe she just doesn't like the teacher. Who knows? That's a fair question. I would probably ask the same thing. Like, why, if she doesn't want to do it, like, why do you keep asking? Maybe she doesn't feel good. Maybe she's embarrassed. Maybe she's shy. Whatever. I feel like it's an honest question to ask. Some of these questions the woman was pretending parents were asking, because I still don't think it's real. But like some of these questions, I'm just like, well, that's an, like, you're providing a service. I'm assuming someone is paying you for these services. So if they ask you a question and you're talking about how arrogant they are, well, you're pretty arrogant if you think you don't have to answer the mother, because you were the one with her child. You were the one in charge of her child. So if she asking you, what is making my child want to hit another child? What happened beforehand? That's a fair question. So you have an attitude like, oh my gosh, I have to do my job and answer your question. But you're trying to say something about the parent who's having an attitude with you. She's the customer. Customer's always right. I know everyone hates that term, but it's true. She's the one paying you. If she asks a question, customer service in the old days, I guess like new days, people just do whatever they want. But I'm not paying for people to do whatever they want, so I wouldn't be returning. But in the olden days when I was, you know, working for people, you would respond like, well, this child did nothing to her and da 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 da. Like, what did you expect the parent to just take your word for it? She doesn't know you. She knows her child. That's who her allegiance is to. So of course she's going to ask you a million questions first. Of course she's going to be defensive because it's her child. What do you want her to just throw her child under the bus to make you feel warm and fuzzy? Like, you're not that important. I think this is what the real issue is. It's like, this is like a family unit here. Even if it's just a mom and a child, like, it's them against you. So however the mom wants to take it, that's how she's taking it. And you can decide what you want to do from there. But that's their crew right there. And that's one reason why you should be having a family, because you can have your own little crew against the other crew. That's just how that goes. Strength in numbers. People can get mad, whatever. That's how it's always been. And these are the things people are not understanding when they decide, oh, I don't feel like having kids and I want to act like I'm better than everybody because I didn't have kids. But yet I'm angry for some reason that no one understands why. And then I'm going to talk about hypothetical kids that I said I didn't want. Like, make it make sense.
Be wreaking havoc on the world, and it's gonna fall back on you. And you will be a lucky one if they don't do some shit that you have to pay for. If children, y'all aren't able to teach your children about emotional control.
What is she talking about right now? Like, kids are gonna do something, we gotta pay for it? Like, what are you talking about? Yeah, kids are kids. They probably will be doing something we're gonna have to pay for. Maybe, maybe not. It depends on whoever's dealing with this. A lot of people understand it's a child, they're not going to be annoying about it. But again, what does that have to do with her? Are you going to help us pay for it? Why do you care? They're wreaking havoc where? Doing what? From singing Pound Town?
Emotional intelligence, about working through their feelings and their emotions. Y'all can't do it because teach them, because you don't even know how to do it. Parents are looking for an escape.
Now she's a psychologist and she's treating all the parents that she doesn't know and telling us what we can and can't do. We're probably more stable mentally than she ever will be, because she doesn't really seem to have a lot of self-awareness, motivation to better herself, because she's childless. So she thinks she could just live a raunchy, raggedy life because she doesn't have any children. She has nothing to live for, basically. It's just her. That's essentially what she says. So we have to be perfect as parents, because we have a big job to do. Like, we didn't know that already. So it's like, yeah, I do have a big job to do. And that's why I'm not going to leave it in the hands of random people like her to tell me what I need to be doing with my child, because it's a pretty big job. So I'm going to take it from here, and I will determine who and when I listen to others. If I need to listen to anyone else, it probably won't be her, probably my mother or another elder or a trusted person that I know who has proven themselves to be credible and intelligent, it's not going to be just every Tom, Dick, and Jane, because it is a big job. It's a very, very important job. So yes, I'm extremely selective and careful or who I listen to, who I take advice from, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. Period.
You should have thought about that before you had children, because now you got a job to do that's larger than you.
That's so interesting. For someone who has no kids, she still knows a lot about people who have kids. This is her third time saying it's a big job. So I think parents are aware we have a big job. Now, some parents can take it seriously. Some take it unserious. There's literally parents who just run off. They're complete deadbeats. So I think the parent who stays, who makes sure the child's fed, has a roof over their head, clothes on their back, they're already doing a really great job just off that. And no, I'm not saying, yes, you can play Pound Town, whatever you're doing. But if they do some things that aren't perfect because they're human, that child will be okay most likely, because children have been through a lot worse and kids are very resilient. But to sit there and pile on more bullshit on top of like what a parent who's actually in the child's life is already doing, it's just ridiculous. Like, you don't really know anyone. You heard some random person on TikTok ranting about parents. Her story is not believable, and she's not smart enough, because she hates parents so much that she just wanted to run, take it and run with it, because it was her chance to judge us and judge parents and go off on parents. Like, this is like she couldn't wait to put on her old lady glasses and start preaching and chastising and telling parents what we can and can't do. And she just sounds ridiculous. She sounds ridiculous. It is a big job to do, but parents are still human. And if parents want to go out with friends, they can. If they want to go out for drinks, they can do that. They want to travel, they can do that. If they want to take a break and drop the kids off with grandma and grandpa and take off for a week, they can do that. They can do whatever they want. They can do whatever they want. And I think maybe that's why she doesn't have kids, because she thinks she's just going to be tied down to the kids and she can't do nothing in her life. That would be her choice. That would be her choice. What I would not be doing is coming onto TikTok to tell her how to raise her child, though. That's how we're different.
I know this shit is hard. I know it's not fun. That's why I don't want to do it.
How does she know it's hard when she doesn't do it? And it is fun. We love people who have their kids. They usually love their kids. And they like having fun with their kids. That's why they have kids. That's why they even go on to have more kids past the first one, because they like the first one a lot. And so they may have another one and another one and another one, like I did. And then they next thing you know, they have five and the kids are pretty freaking awesome. And you're a family unit and you're minding your business. And you're having random strangers on TikTok that are angry that they can't get in your business and tell your family what to do with their lives. Girl, you got to get a life, honey. You need to go get a man and, ooh, Lord, I want to say have some kids, but I'm worried for the kids with you. You know better than I do whether you should be having kids. And you're probably right that maybe you shouldn't, because you seem very high strung, very angry, need some help, need some therapy. Get a plant, get something that you can go and boss around. Like, it seems like she needs to like have somebody to boss around. Maybe she should be a teacher. That's scary, but I mean, she seems like she would be very strict and by the book. I don't know, but it's like she needs someone to boss around. And parents just ain't it. Parents are not it for you, honey. Like, I know she wants it to be it. I don't know why she wants to try to have some power over parents, but hate to bust her bubble. No one cares what she's talking about. No one cares. There may be some young parents somewhere who's still impressionable and still be willing to listen to you, but I'm telling you now, the older parents are laughing at you. We're not going to listen. You're going to turn off TikTok and keep it moving.
Oh, I wouldn't want my children to be around the likes of...
When was she having children, y'all? Please don't have children. That's the only advice I give her. Don't have kids. No. Honestly, her having children might be good, because then she can boss her kids around. It's like, please turn off the TikTok. Like, hopefully her child can tell her mom, turn off, step away from the TikTok. You're angry. You're going to be doing the angry TikTok videos. Like, please just walk away. But I just feel like she's so highly strung. It's really hard to call it. I've had people who I thought would not be good parents, and they ended up being like really good parents. So you really just never know, you know? And I definitely feel like she needs somebody around to kind of micromanage. I kind of would feel sorry for a child if that was the case, because then her child would be like, couldn't breathe, you know, because her mom's smothering you with all this helicopter parenting. Like, she won't let the child breathe and live and enjoy a 21st century life with her tablet. So maybe she should just stick to a partner, maybe. Like, it's like clear she's single. It's like, girl, you are angry and miserable. And it's so obvious. It's so obvious. We're actually going to go through the rest of her TikTok, because I have to know who this lady, what is going on in her life? What's happening with you, woman, that you need to conquer the parents and have them listen to you? Because it's not going to happen. And I just want to know what makes people like this. Because there's actually a lot of childless people who are like this. They either really hate children, and or they really hate parents, and or they really want to like judge us and have us listening to them. And what are we like? It's some anger there. And all I could think is, you wanted kids and couldn't have them? Or like, what is happening here? I need to know.
Of y'all's kids. They are eliminating so much knowledge. Like, children can't write in cursive. They don't teach them how to write in cursive. They don't teach them how to write checks. Like, these children, granted, you.
She don't know what she's talking about. She's just talking. She's babbling. She's talking about something that has nothing to do with parents. That's the schools that cut that out. This is what I mean by all the stuff that they just throw. Oh, it's the parents. It's the parents. It's the parents. 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 It's, what? Like, that ain't got nothing to do with parents. Like, we don't have any control over that. Yes, we could raise a fuss, but if it's cut out because the budget's not there, or they think kids don't need it, or whatever. I mean, the bottom line is America does not put children first either. And that's probably why they're creating citizens who don't put children first. But that's the school thing. Take that up with your local school if you're so upset. If it's so bothering you that children are leaving and they don't know how to write in cursive? Wow, that must be the end of the world. The world must be ending as we speak, because children are graduating and they do not. Like, how much do we write in cursive? I'll wait. Because I just write my signature in cursive, if that. And I wouldn't really call it writing. It's more like a scribble. So this is what she's worried about. Oh my gosh, we're going to reap what we sow, because the kids can't write in cursive. And it's not even the parents' fault. It's the schools that took it out of the school. Parents were upset about that. But this is what happens, I guess, when you're not a parent, but you're putting your nose where it doesn't belong. So you're on TikTok using your, I guess because she has too much free time. That's what it sounds like. Maybe she just heard a video and was like, I'm so angry that parents are letting kids have their tablets and I need to go vent on TikTok. Ah! And now she's talking about kids writing in cursive and writing checks. And she even admitted herself how stupid that was. Children don't, no one writes checks anymore, honey. We are in the 21st century. Like, you're showing your age. And whether she likes it or not, technology is the future. So just like our faces were glued to our TVs, the kids are on the tablets. At least tablets, you can control a little bit more of what information your child's consuming. Like, my children is very censored. I have like learning cartoons on there and, you know, little games where they can do some learning as well. So tablets are not always a bad thing. Of course, you want to limit screen time or whatever, but you do know the kids are in school for like the bulk of the day, like 5 days a week. So no matter what, how much a parent is handing a tablet to a child, I don't think it'll ever be too much, unless they're just letting them stay up all night with it, because the average child comes home and they have like maybe a few hours with their parent before they have to go to bed. So there's homework, there's dinner, there's baths, there's all this other stuff, you know, hanging out with parent, whatever. If they can get an hour or two of tablet time each day, of free tablet time, children could, they could use that. They could use that mental break of not having to be doing something for everyone else for a couple of hours out of their freaking day. Imagine how nice that would be. To not have to listen to anyone telling you what to do and just letting your child roam a bit free once a day before they have to go to bed and just do them. So if that means watching cartoons, getting on your tablet, whatever. Like, chill the fuck out. Chill the fuck out. Look at her face right now. I mean, she's just so angry. And the only thing I can think is jealousy. You're jealous. because you do want a child and it didn't work out for you for whatever reason. You need to unpack that.
Really need to write checks anymore. But these children don't really know how to function in society. I also understand there's...
The kids are functioning just fine in society. I have no clue what she's talking about. Function how? What, getting jobs? If we want to complain about anything, this is how out of touch she is. Let's complain about the kids not being taught how to read by the schools. But that would mean you'd have to hold someone else accountable besides the parents. And that just won't do because she clearly has a bone to pick with the parents for whatever reason. She hates parents for whatever reason. And that's anyone who just decided to just... I was in the conversation and someone just kept saying, well, it's the parents' fault. And they were like, well, that's kind of like what the school would have to do. Or that's kind of the artist who's... Or it's the government who's not... No, it's the parents' fault. It's like, okay. So this is how you say, I don't like parents because I'm jealous of them or whatever, without saying it. That's essentially what you need to be doing. Just admit you hate parents, because you can say it's the parents' fault you want to, but if it's not our fault, it's not our fault. Deal with it.
Universal energetic shift happening in the world right now, and a lot of these things are a part of it, and we're moving into a different space energetically, and there's going to be bumps and things of that nature. But that's why it's on you as a parent to teach your child, not teachers. Y'all think your job is
okay, so now the teachers don't have to do their job. It's the parents' job to teach our children. So what are they going to school for all day then?
As the parent is to literally babysit and yell at y'all's kids all day.
So she said it's not the teacher's job to teach our children. It's the parents' job. But then she's complaining that parents think teachers are just meant to babysit and yell at our kids. I don't know any parent one that wants people yelling at their kids, but which one is it? Do they teach our kids or are they a babysitter? This is how weird she is. She's a hypocrite. She's confused. She's contradicting herself because she's angry at parents for whatever reason. She's just babbling about trying to find something wrong to blame parents. No, it is absolutely the teacher's job, who signed up for that, who went on an interview, who went to school and applied and did the most to get that government position, because it's state funded with parents' tax dollars and everyone else's tax dollars. So it would behoove people. It would be in people's best interest as citizens of this country, as a resident of that city or county or whatever, wherever that school is, to hold the schools accountable, because your money is going to pay for things there as well. Parents are not getting paid to do your bidding. Whether you like it or not, you don't have control over parents like you wish you did for whatever sick fucking reason. You do have control over your government. Those are people that you hired. Those are people that you're paying. Those are people that you elected. So go talk to them, because they actually do have a job that they applied for, that they went to an interview for, that they went to college for, to go do this job. And they have a big job because they're standing around in front of people's kids 5 days a week, 6 to 8 hours out of the day. And you're sitting here saying it's not their job to teach the youth the future of the country. How stupid do you sound? This is embarrassing. And you wonder why America is on the decline, because we don't expect anything from the school system. To have no expectations is the first sign of failure. It's inexcusable. It's unacceptable to sit there and fix your face and say, oh, it's not the teacher's job to teach. Then why do they exist? Why are they there if they're not a babysitter either? Take your pick. This is what happens when you're angry at people. You're all over the place. You don't have your rational talking points in place, because you don't really have any rational talking points. You are just angry and you're yelling sporadically at people you don't know. And there's a lot of parents out there and they don't like you. I can tell you that. If they're older, they don't appreciate what you're doing, because I know I don't. And I'm a pretty rational person. So usually what I feel, a lot of people feel the same way. There may be some people who need some validation from you. I'm not one of them. So the ones who do, they might be trying to co-sign with you. More power to them if they want to follow a random stranger. But me personally, who's intelligent and of sound mind and a free thinker, I just don't agree with like almost anything you've said. That's why I did my video, because you're out here spewing nonsense and you're absolutely going to get a response back, because just like you think you can judge parents, parents can judge you.
And when they go to school, the teacher is supposed to actually raise them and teach them about life.
No one's thinking like, what is she talking about? That's the last thing a lot of parents want, is a teacher telling our child anything. Your child's going to school because it's the law. By law, they're supposed to be teaching our children certain things. There's literally an entire like act in the state of Maryland that they have to be teaching your child. They have to meet the need to make sure your child learns what they're supposed to be learning. They have to be at a certain level, like reading, math, whatever. They have to meet that need. So this is, again, the nonsense she's spewing, and that information is free. It's online. You can Google it. You sound ridiculous. There is no one that goes to work that isn't responsible for their job. If you show up at work and you're collecting a check and you're on payroll and you signed up for that job, you got hired to do a job, that's absolutely your job. You're a teacher. You're there to teach. You're not there to raise my kids. You're there to teach. And hopefully, if you have any kind of damn sense, you will continue whatever we're doing at home. Teach kids. I mean, keep the manners and everything consistent. Obviously, if kids are not learning this stuff at home, which a lot of them aren't, they're not going to continue into the real world either. I don't think she learned anything at home either, the way she's acting. So if children are not learning simple, polite manners, then no, the teacher probably won't have any real influence on the child, because the parents are like, you don't have to do this. And despite what people hate to say, no, parents are the first teacher. Parents do have the most influence on their child until they get older. Now they're like, oh, we're listening to our peers or whatever. But parents still have a good amount of influence. It just depends on the child, like if they want to listen to their parents. But whether kids are rebelling against parents or listening to parents, we are influencing them. And sometimes they're young and they're dumb and they're doing stupid things. We've all been there. That doesn't mean they don't hear what you're saying. They just may not understand it or be able to comprehend what you're trying to say because their little brains are not fully developed yet. That's a whole other video.
That's how it seems, at least on the outside looking in, because a lot.
Well, I can tell her since she's on the outside looking in that that's absolutely not true. I wish a teacher would be thinking they're about to raise my child. Nobody has kids to be handing their parenting rights over, because you really can hand your parental rights over. People have done it. People do it every day. So if that's really what parents wanted to do, they could just do that. So I can guarantee you a lot of people, I think the majority parents, I know I can speak for myself as an actual real parent, that I'm not wanting anyone to have authority and raise my child. That's partly why we're having this conversation on this video right now, to let childless people know that you will not have authority over parents. You're never going to be able to judge us to a point where it's going to have any kind of effect on us. Some parents may be affected. That's on them. But me personally, I do have an issue with it, because no, I don't intend for anyone to raise my child. Teachers can like that, not like it. That's their problem. I'm the mother and they will know it. Because there are some who be trying to do what they want to do. And it's like, have your own kids, raise your kids. Like, I'm, you're not going to be telling me how to raise my child. Like, this is what we do at home. That's what I want to have done there. And of course, we can compromise and try to work within reason. But at the end of the day, I'm going to have the most influence over my own child. So no, I do not expect a school or anyone else to be raising my child. Absolutely not. They're there because by law, they have to be there to learn. And even with that being said, they still come home every day with me knowing I'm going to probably be teaching them a lot of things over again.
All kids don't know how to function. And if they can't function, they can't work, because they're not going to be able to sit wherever they want to sit when they go to their job. They're not going to be able to tell their boss, "You ain't my mama," which means they ain't going to be able to make money, which means they're going to be your problem for the rest of their life.
She wants us to suffer so damn bad. You do not have to take care of adult children. The kids that are your children, your kids, they're adults. You don't have to take care of them, parents. If you haven't reached that stage yet where your child is an adult, I can tell you, having an adult son, that you are not liable for your child anymore after they hit 18. I would not recommend kicking your child out the house if they don't have anywhere to go and don't have their lives together, which usually they won't. But what she's saying once more is incorrect. If your child can't function and they're looking crazy and don't want to keep a job and they're 18 and grown, it's not falling back on you. It only falls back on you if you want it to. I know childless people hate to hear that oh my gosh, parents are freedom. They have some freedom. They get to have children and still have freedom. Oh no, oh no, oh no. Deal with it. Like, I don't know what to tell you. You clearly need therapy. You need some help. There's something wrong with you. Because you essentially want people to suffer, and I don't know why. The only thing I can think is you're jealous that we have children and we're not going to suffer forever because we have children, which I think is so strange, because I'm like, it's like they want to validate their reason or justify their reason for not having children. You don't have to have kids. It's okay. It's a free country. It's not a law that you have to have children. Like, I don't know if you need talking points to talk to your parents about what. You don't have to explain yourself to people. You're a grown person, I'm assuming. Just say you don't want kids. That's it. Stop caring what people think. That's always part of the problem. This is dumb at this point. If you want to have kids, have them. If you don't, don't. But attacking parents is dumb. It's not going to change anything. I mean, y'all probably always attacked us and we just didn't have to hear it because of the internet. The internet wasn't around. But now we have to hear it. And it's like, this is making me want to do what you're doing to us and judge you. Because I don't appreciate it. Essentially giving you pushback.
They're going to be living in your house, burdening you. And that's going to be exactly what y'all deserve.
You see that? Nasty, 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 ugly behavior. Just ugly. Glad she doesn't have any kids, because she would have kids that would be bullying others. I could see that. She would have a very ugly demeanor and be teaching her children to be hateful to people for whatever reason. Like, this is the way she handles things not going her way. Just let me hop online and bully others. Because she doesn't have any kids. So why is she even online talking about the fake ballerina's video? Do you have, like, she didn't say she was a teacher. She has not explained. The only person she brought remotely close was her nephew. And I still don't get the connection. The nephew has a parent. So what are you are childless supposedly for a reason. So that would make me think you'd just be like, oh, that's not my problem. I don't have any kids. Like, that's what I would think a childless person would do with that information. Like, if I saw fake ballerina and I didn't have any kids, I would just keep scrolling, honestly, because why do I care? It's like, wow, that's crazy. And I would just keep scrolling. I mean, what do you want? That's the behavior. I'm going to need y'all to have that energy, childless people, because that's the energy y'all have for everything else related to parents. You're not coming over saying, oh, you're stressed out. Let me come help you watch your children. Oh, you don't have money this week for your groceries. Let me put some money in your account. You have a complete I don't give a F attitude about all the other things related to parenting. But this is the thing you got to get on TikTok and talk about. This is what really just grinds your gears. It's kids singing in Pound Town. Now you suddenly need to judge us and give us your 3 cents. You don't know us from Adam. You don't know our lives. You don't know what else we're doing for our children and what we've been through and what we're going through. And you're still running your mouth talking about nonsense and wanting us so badly to suffer when the jig is up. I mean, honestly, a lot of parents are already struggling because we live in a really expensive, racist, psycho country. So if that makes your negative ass feel better, there you go. Hope that made your day.
Nothing inherently wrong with a grown-ass woman making a song like Pound Town. But it is on you as parents to make sure your children aren't listening to these things.
People like her makes me want to let my kids listen to Pound Town. That's where I'm at these days. Like, I'm literally going to always be a rebel. I'm not going to do it because I love my kids more than I don't like her. But you get what I'm saying. Because there are parents that are letting their kids listen to it. And what? What is she going to do? Nothing.
Hey, play them Princess Tiana. And they talking about they want to ballet to Pound Town. Y'all are fucking up. Big time. I would never want my kids to be around y'all's kid. The amount of...
She doesn't have any kids. She doesn't have any kids. And when she has kids, or if she has them, God forbid. Ooh, Lord, that just gave me some anxiety. I'm stressed. We don't want another version of her. Mm-mm. But anyways, if she were to have children, your children don't have to be taking this ballet class. It is most likely a very elective thing to do. It's very voluntary. I've never heard anywhere in life that you need a ballet class to graduate with your high school diploma and your degree and succeed in life. So you don't have to worry about your hypothetical child being around these hypothetical kids.
Energy that I would pour into my child. I don't even have that kind of energy, which is why I'm not going to have children.
But you do have energy to get online and judge parents that you don't know.
And the fact of the matter is, neither do the average parent. They don't have the energy either.
And now she knows the average parent and what we're doing with our lives. I would love to see those statistics because I guess she can tell us what kind of energy we have. How do you even measure that?
Didn't give themselves time to figure out they didn't have the energy. And I will continue to judge parents.
And we will continue to not listen and to continue to not like people like her.
Forever.
And we will continue to judge you. Forever. All right, so we're going to jump through here really quickly. 1 second. So here's her very angry page. Smart Mouth Yogi. You got that right. Is she gay? What's the rainbow about? Anyways. So let's go and see how wonderful her life is. That she is having no kids. She looks angry here.
Cross my heart and hopes to die. Welcome to my dark side. Cross my.
She has problems, clearly.
Cross my heart and hopes to die. Welcome to my dark side.
This is why she doesn't have kids. Literally, she's scaring everyone, including the men who she. The man who she wants to date her. I've yet to see her looking like she's enjoying life. It's like she's just in front of this camera talking. She's not out doing anything. She's not looking like she's living her best life. And she seems miserable, as I suspected. All right, let's see here.
Those innocent eyes.
So I'm finally getting getting around to discussing more on why I decided to be child-free. And the main reason is I don't view parenthood and parent-child relationships like a lot of people. I don't see children as an extension of their parents, thus I wouldn't see my child as an extension of myself. I wouldn't have my child and birth them with expectations and demands of their lifestyle choice, of their career choice, of who they are as individuals and how they choose to operate in the world. To me, parenthood would be about giving the child I voluntarily chose to bring into this world every tool at my disposal, and I have very high standards for that, the tools they need to be savvy in this life, to be successful in this life, and that is a lot. That's very taxing. Children are also very needy. And because I feel like this about parenthood, and I think a lot of people are very selfish for the reasons they have children. They want legacy. They want somebody to take care of them when they're older. They want shallow reasons like me, is they want a mini me, somebody they can dress in cute matching outfits, and that's not a good reason to have a child. I don't think the reward would be worth the risk. And don't get me wrong, I love children. I have plenty of children in my life that I can nurture and that I can assist with in rearing. I just don't want any for myself. I think that children are super needy. I don't like being touched a lot. I don't like people in my personal space a lot. And I think it would drive me literally insane to have someone who literally can't fend for themselves. They need me to literally survive. Can't see that for myself. It would totally rearrange my life in the worst way. And it will also uproot every ounce of freedom I constantly work for. And if more people viewed, parenthood the way I view it, you would think twice about choosing to take care of someone and give them all of yourself for nothing. I vividly recall as a kid not even really wanting to be here. Earth is ghetto. I can't justify bringing a child into this world and, having to deal with.
Earth is ghetto. She is ghetto. She's really angry. She's like one of the females, like, what? Like, ugh. Just always so bitchy. So, like, this lady said here, and I agree with this woman, of course, because, of course, everyone else can't wait to jump and say, I hate kids. Okay, more power to you. Anyways, this woman says, I can so relate, and my children are grown now. When they were children, I felt guilty in a year for me time. Girl, bye. You shouldn't have had kids. This woman said, how sad for you? Wow, I've raised two boys. I think engineer is what that is, and lawyer. They are the joy of my life. I had a wonderful career, I guess, energy or engineer as well, enjoying retirement. And this is what the female says, is this person that's like always angry and bitter. She put, you're probably not the joy of theirs. After all that work, how sad for you. And I put, your life sounds wonderful and happy. Childless people always seem so nasty and miserable to me. Congratulations. So this person said, you do realize most children raised will only be average or below average in success. And she put, even more of a reason to not have any. That's partly pridefulness, exactly. And she put, am I supposed to feel bad about that because I can't? And that's your pride talking. Alter ego thing. I'm like, girl, you are a bitch. You're a bitch. That's the only person that would come on and talk about hypothetical children and people, how they're raising their children. Like, no, you need to go get a life. She's so angry. Sometimes all she do is spend her time on here being angry, like responding to people and being mad. And people like this are so ugly. Like, they don't even realize this is why they're single. Like, she's like one of the females that could be like attractive, but it's like your attitude is so ugly. Like, the guy would go running from you and be with someone less attractive just because their attitude is like way more pleasant.
He is trying to see me. He's trying to see me. He's trying to say what's up. He is trying to see me. Downtown. Going downtown.
Ooh, all right. This woman, the teacher that posted this video, said that she got permission from the parents to post these kids on, you know, her video or whatever. But I don't have their permission, so I didn't feel comfortable posting their faces, so I went ahead and blurred them out. But I want to talk about music for a second, right? Obviously, music is special for everybody. Everybody has their own flavor. When I was young, one of the things I started to notice from hip-hop culture was that it was starting to influence the people around me. When I went to school as a little kid, as an elementary school kid, one year, you know, we playing with G.I. Joes and stuff. The next year, a lot of the kids I went to school with were like all of a sudden thugged out, sagging their pants and doing just the most crazy shit that had nothing to do with what we were doing there at the time. But the reason they were doing that is because what they were doing was they were mimicking what they were seeing on TV. Criss Cross had came out shortly after that, so you had even a lot of kids turning their pants backwards and stuff. That's how much music has an influence on people. Young men identify with the rappers that they saw on TV, right? Because those rappers and those hip-hop artists were a reflection of what masculinity is supposed to be. They're rich. They're successful. You know what I'm saying? They have style. They have women around them, right? Everybody wanted that. Everybody wanted to obtain that. But what did the lyrics say in a lot of those songs? Kill your fellow brother, right? Kill another black man to obtain certain things. Even though some of these people wasn't even living these lifestyles. Sell drugs. You out here selling drugs, you might end up in jail or dead, right? That part, you know, is glorified. And all that has an influence on the mind. So when people criticize the young ladies that are making music right now, who are being glorified and pushed, you see, when you watch this video, these young, what is these, kindergartners, first graders, right? Regurgitating their lyrics, right? And if you go into the comments, it's mostly women that are applauding this and thinking that this is cute. There's nothing cute about this because y'all are the first ones to get on here and say that words are affirmations and spells, right? So if these kids are regurgitating this shit in their head, and yeah, they're using the tame lyrics right there, but you don't think they're not hearing the raunchier lyrics too? And they're not regurgitating that stuff in their head about booty holes being brown and coochies? They don't hear that shit and internalize that shit into a certain way? They do. And why do you think that it's our youth that is targeted in that way? Think about it. It's demonic shit, bro. It's demonic shit. People are saying hip-hop, if the sales are in the tank, hip-hop is dying. Good, I say. If it's going to be this demonic, right? If you watch that, to me, that shit is demonic. Y'all can think that it's cute all y'all want, but if you have a classroom full of young black kids singing that bullshit, singing Sexy Red and fucking and Ice Spice and all that shit in the classroom, it's that we done. We fried. Music can be something completely different and give you a positive affirmation, have you singing shit in your head that make you feel good. That's why people always go back to, oh, R&B at this time was really good, or the 70s music or the 80s music was so good, because they wasn't talking about demonic bullshit, right? It just wasn't. They wasn't talking about the raunchiest shit. Even if they did, they alluded to in such a way that it was tasteful. You get what I'm saying? Or it was cleverly put in the song through verse, right? They've gotten it down to a mathematical science as far as the production and everything, that the songs are so catchy that these kids can know and regurgitate those lyrics probably better than they can fucking spell their goddamn name. It's sad. Sad. It's sad for black people. I'm sorry. It's sad for black people. It just is. I don't know how else to say it. It's sad for us, bro. But whatever. I'm just an old fucking dusty old man. What do I know? I know that I'm an artist, and people will say that it's not the artist's responsibility. It's not an artist's responsibility to, you know, culture the youth, so to speak, you know, to influence the youth. Yes, it is. Who else is fucking influencing them? And even if the parents are directly in their life every fucking day, which a lot of parents are, you're not going to ever influence your kids as much as the artists that they fucking revere. It's just the truth.
Hey everyone, it's your favorite black single mother here, millennial introvert. My name is Samantha, and today I want to talk about this brother who just went in and he said a whole word. Oh Lord. Okay, so today we are talking about Pound Town by Sexy Red. I first heard about this video, I guess it went viral with a so-called ballerina. I do not believe she's really a ballerina anything. I have not found any proof anywhere that she is related to ballet in any sort of way. I do feel like she did that video for likes and clickbait and shock and awe and so on and so forth. And so I am now going to be doing subsequent videos to prove my point. But like I said before, if she wants to prove that that was really her story and those things really happened, I will be glad to see some receipts. I definitely agree with this guy. He's an artist, and I think it's very disingenuous for people to continue to try to act like music does not affect real life. That's exactly what art does, is it influences culture. It always has, it always will. And it's been a whole play in my face moment for the last 2 decades as people try to pretend that this awful music has not had an impact on basically completely crushing our culture, to the point where anyone who will listen, I let them know I am not, that is not Black culture. Like, this ratchetness is not, that's not the only part of Black culture, because I'm Black too, and I don't live like that. I don't want any part of that. So that everybody's race has different types of culture. We're not a monolith. So if you're, you know, say like you're white, you can have the wealthy people who are preppy or whatever they're doing. And then you could have the trailer park people, and then you could have the redneck. So that's how Black culture is. We are not all just in the hood living that life. And we and our family would never be doing any parts of that. Like, of course, your children, as they get older, they do stuff and you can't control it anymore because now they're adults. And when they're closer to becoming an adult, like say they're 15, 16, 17, even 14, it gets that much harder to try to control what they're hearing, because they're going to work, they're going to school, they're leaving the house, and you have to go live your adult life. You have to go to work or whatever you're doing with yourself. So you can't be like following your kid around like a shadow. And anyone with common sense knows that. So I do think the onus is on the government to censor the music. I do think it's disgusting how everything is being put on the parents' shoulders. And I'm telling you now, you're going to fail. Like, if you're waiting for the parents to save the day for this entire country, it's not going to happen, because it's not the parents. It's not just the parents' fault. A lot of times it's not the parents' fault at all. A lot of times the parents are actually doing everything they can or everything on their end to ensure their children don't hear certain music, don't watch certain TV programs, et cetera, et cetera. But to some degree, it's almost impossible. Like this artist was saying, it's almost that, you know, from the video I just showed, it's almost impossible, because it's like, there are way too many channels. Like, am I going to sit next to my child all day, every day? I'm not going to. I'm just not. And I feel like people who didn't have children or don't have kids or whatever, they're kind of just like sitting back like, oh, I told you so. It's so hard. And I just don't get the point of that. Like, I don't get why they're happy that we're struggling trying to raise our children in a raggedy world, because they are in the same raggedy world. So I don't know if people need, I feel like humans always need to feel like they're doing better than other humans. I don't understand that ideal either. Like, I'm just like, does it matter what you're doing? Because what you're doing may not be necessarily better. Like, just because it's looking good right now, 20, 50 years from now, you may be looking crazy because you're single and you're lonely or whatever. Or like the holidays coming, not even that long away. Say the holidays come, you don't have anybody to spend time with. A lot of stuff, I do feel like they are bitter. They are angry about something and not having that conversation. And that's something they're going to have to deal with in their own time that parents have nothing to do with. I'm like, I've made my choices in my life and I'm living my life, and that's what it is. And I don't know if people feel like, oh, I'm being affected by this. They probably are. You know, I know for me, we were living in a nice area in the suburbs, but we were hearing about people getting the young kids, like carjacking people, and the violence, like they bring guns to school and having fights and shooting people and killing people off. And it was awful. And I remember one of our politicians was like, where are the parents? She's a parent herself. And it's like, girl, bye. Like, where are the parents? You're a whole politician. If you can't get it under control, like, what do you want us to do? So I feel like she did end up like kind of backing off that statement. But it's like, people, once they heard it, they're like, yes, we get to blame the parents for everything. And it's like, you can blame us all day, but I'm not doing more than what I'm already doing, because I'm already doing a lot and it's exhausting already. And I feel like the onus needs to be on the government to fix what they are allowing, because they're the ones in power. They're the ones I pay to represent me. They're the ones that we vote in into office to represent us, and they need to be protecting their citizens instead of letting everybody and mama run across the border and put us in further danger. They need to be protecting their citizens and doing their jobs, which they don't do. And of course, like, I will always push back because there are a lot of people who are just getting off scot-free, whether it's the school system, the government, whomever. It's always everybody else getting off, just getting to sit on their ass and collect a check while the parents are like, they're like, oh, the parents. I don't make the music. I don't regulate the laws. I don't teach the kids at school. I'm not a teacher. So no, it's not the parents. It's like, sometimes it's the parents, but it's not just the parents. We're not making music by Sexy Red. We're not dictating what gets played on the radio. We're not dictating what's being released on these networks, on the TV networks, etc. There's so much media out there. It's ridiculous. And so it will be a community effort. You know, people are trying to say, oh, you have a big job. It's like, you're correct. So that means I'm busy. And that means that I'm not going to be doing more than what I'm doing. And that's just what it is. So parents are doing a great job, I feel, based on my own research. We're doing a wonderful job and we're doing the best we can. And I think we've been blamed long enough. The reading statistics that I just got back after I did my research for my video before last were startling, to say the least. And where is the outrage? Like, I don't hear anything from anyone. And I think people either don't know, or they just want to like point the finger back at the parents. You can do whatever you want to, but if my child's going to school and they're purposely not teaching him phonics, then he will basically, it's like basically confusing the what I'm teaching him every day. So he comes home, then he goes to school, and it's like, children are going to be confused. It's like, which method am I using? Who do I listen to? Et cetera, et cetera. And is that really fair? Like, you have a young child who's trying to learn how to read for the first time, and you've got like adults on two different sides telling him, okay, you do it this way. No, you do it this way. That's not fair. It's not fair. And there's been plenty of study and research that proves that phonics is the way to go. So why are we not using our brains and our common sense and just simply going with phonics? It's that simple. So like I said before, blaming the parents, it may make you feel good because you don't have children for whatever reason. Again, like, I don't know you. I'm not a doctor. I'm not a psychic. I don't know. I mean, we are psychic, but that's another story. So I don't know people like that. And so I don't know why you don't have children, but just sit here and try to point the finger. You can pile stuff on it all you want to, but I am telling you, I'm only going to do what I can do, which is my best. And that's it. Just like, you need to be doing your best, and that's it. And it's like, people need to contact their Congress people or whomever. And I feel like, honestly, if people really want to change, the ones who have more time should do those things. Like, don't sit here and resting in femininity and having a soft life, but then complaining that the kids are shooting up the neighborhoods. Like, okay. You know what I'm saying? Like, if you're talking to the parents and they're saying, we are doing our part, but the children are still getting access to guns, or there's still music on the radios, there's a hot mess, stuff like that, then somebody else has to do something different, because this obviously isn't, whatever we're doing now isn't working. It's just not working. And then getting fed up and saying, I'm going to yell at the parents, especially when the parents are not even the problem to begin with, it's just redundant at this point. It's extremely redundant, because it's like, okay, so you want me to do what differently? Oh, what I was doing yesterday and the day before? Okay, no problem. I'm going to keep doing that. Thank you. Bye. Get out of my face. And that's pretty much how it goes. It's like, I'm not changing. I'm just not. I'm going to dig in my heels, and I'm literally going to continue to be the same mother that I've always been, because I know I'm doing a good job. And the people who need to be held accountable at this point need to be the government and the school system and the music industry. And that's the real problem. And you can't expect people who already have their hands full, when you said yourself, you know, we're busy, you know, we have a lot on our plates, et cetera, et cetera. So if you're aware of this, then why are you waiting for us to make further changes than what we already have to do? That would be stupid at this point. Like, it would be extremely silly to sit here and say, hey, we see that your plate is full and mine's empty, but we're going to sit on our ass and wait for you to go fight them. I'm not doing that. I'm just not going to do it. Like, I'll just give you the heads up now. I'm not doing it. It's like, raising kids, that's the part I'm doing for our society with little to no help. So I'm already pulling my weight. When are you going to pull yours? So that's all I wanted to say. excellent video from his brother. He is right. Art is like, in life imitates art. Sometimes art may imitate life, but they are, either way, they're both very closely aligned and intertwined with each other. Like, it's very, really disingenuous. It's not ignorant, because you all know better. It's disingenuous to pretend like, oh, it's just music. It's just entertainment. What are you talking about? Like, okay, well, if it's just music and entertainment, then why are you talking to us on TikTok? I hope that what happens with this conversation is that people, because I feel like people are starting to get fed up, and I'm like, good, finally. And they're trying to blame up parents because they want us to do something. What do you want us to do different? Go tell Sexy Red to turn off her, stop making the music she's making? Like, no, we're going to let this go to fever pitch if we have to. Like, everyone who buys her music and is totally cool with this music being played on the radio or whatever, you are essentially saying you're supporting this music getting to our little kids' ears, because everyone who listens to this music, whether they have kids or not, they are bringing this music and introducing it to our children. So I actually was going to do a separate video to show all the people who listen to Sexy Red's music and who actually really does bring this music to our kids, from the school system to parents to the generations that are actually knowing this music versus the ones who don't, and so on and so forth. So thanks for watching, everyone. I'm hoping that this will open up a conversation that's been very muchly needed. I have been just yelling. I feel like I've been yelling from the rooftops for the longest, like trying to tell people, like, it's the music, it's the music, it's the music. And there's something about Black people where we just don't feel like we have to be held accountable for anything. Yes, I know we were enslaved, but that doesn't mean we get to run the country and ourselves to the ground because our ancestors went through something that was atrocious. We do need reparations that comes from somewhere else that has nothing to do with, oh, I'm just going to get do what I want. It just never is going to work like that. That's completely lawlessness, and we're seeing the effects of that. We're seeing the result of that. You have to have standards and boundaries, and this music is ridiculous. We don't own the music. That's what makes it even worse, is that we don't own this music. It's another group of people who own this music. We all know it. And they're allowing this music to be pumped into our families, communities and whatever. And like this guy said, I mean, children don't listen to their parents after a certain period. They purposely, I mean, almost from the beginning, they don't want to listen to us, to be honest. I mean, that's why we're always running around telling them no and whatever. They're fighting us or having a whole temper tantrum while you're trying to keep them alive. It starts very young, and then it goes all the way into adulthood, where it takes them a while to finally mature and realize, like, oh, my parents were on my side the whole time. So again, like I said, it's very disingenuous to be like, oh, why the parents. No, the parents are most likely saying all the things they're supposed to be saying, which is turn that ratchet music off, or you're not allowed to listen to that in my house, et cetera, et cetera. And the kids are like, okay, we're defiant. We're going to leave and we're going to listen to it. You know, like, say, like, they have a lot of them have smartphones. How much can you dictate them their smartphone? I mean, you do so much with it, you might as well just take it back, because it's not going to even be usable at that point. So people need to think more clearly, and hopefully this conversation can continue and we can start to work to, at minimum, I feel like, at least get the music censored again, at least have it cleaned up on the radio stations just to start, because this ain't it. Like, no one should all be having access to this song. A lot of people haven't even heard of her, and it's just everywhere. It's like the main version that everyone should know should be the radio version. I thought that's how it used to be. Like, you had to buy the graphic version, like in Walmart or something. I can't remember. But like, if you wanted like the actual original or the more vulgar or whatever you call it, I can't remember, but if you wanted like the more graphic version, you would have to like go to the store or something and actually get like the graphic. Like, it wasn't the one that was being like filtered out everywhere. So I would love to go back to that and make it less accessible, make it harder for people to get to that version. Or better yet, why not create the version at all? What was so necessary about those lyrics that they had to be said? Did it save the planet? Like, I just don't understand. Like, it's not even attractive. The music's doesn't make you feel good. It just vile. It's vile. It's something that should be kept between you and your man, whoever you sleep with that night, or whatever. Why, again, it's like we're in a group chat we didn't ask for, and I know too much that I don't want to know. I mean, it's really that simple. It's like, this is a song that you put out into the public, and it's just too stank. It's too public. It's like, keep this private between you and whomever you're talking about. Like, I don't need to hear about this. Like, it's just way too, it's too intimate. It's too graphic. It's too gross. Every time I just hear the first line, I just want to throw up in my mouth a little bit. Like, it's just like, no, never going to be attractive. So yeah, let me know what you all think about this video with his brother and what he's saying, and how alarming is it to see these daycare workers teaching these babies. I think they were actually in daycare. Someone said they could have been, he said they could have been four or five or first grade or kindergarten or something. They looked little, but they could have been kindergarten. And either way, they're little. It's scary. Like, that's not what their introduction to learning should be. You're literally in a learning environment for learning. So why are you singing lyrics to Sexy Red? And I'm just wondering, where is the outrage from these parents that have these babies on this video? And the guy was saying that the artist that just did the video, but he was saying that they were saying they got permission from the parents to take a video of their children and show their face. I really find it hard to believe. But the fact that I'm hearing nothing from anyone makes me feel like, okay, maybe they're telling the truth. So I don't know. It's a lot. It's a lot to take in. Like I said, I feel like I'm playing catch up because I had not even heard of this video with the fake ballerina until maybe a few days ago. And I've been really on top of this ever since. It's just like, this is a lot. And I feel like it is a turning point. It is a turning point. Because I don't know why hers is different, but it is. I just don't know why it's different. I don't know if it's because she's a woman, because she's a brown-skinned, dark-skinned woman. Like, I just don't know what's so different about her, because I'm like, I grew up loving Lil' Kim. She was, like, my favorite artist when I was a kid, and where was everybody crying to my parents about me listening to Lil' Kim? I mean, I was probably, like, 16 or 15, thought I was grown, 17 or whatever. And I turned out just fine. I'm not overly anything. And I'm just living my life, being a good mom. So there you have it. And I would love to see the music, you know, I would love to see it just go away completely, to be honest. I really, really wish. Because I just don't see the benefit. Like, I feel like if it needs to be that graphic, like, you need to be, it's almost like going to get porn, how it used to be. You had to go to, like, those adult stores, like, I feel like that's how it should be. Like, if you want that kind of raunchy, ratchet music, you should have to go to, like, an adult store to buy those CDs or whatever. Or, like, go to some special dark place or some place to purchase that specifically. It shouldn't just be fresh for consumption, all across circulation, being brought literally into the school. It's just, we're tired of it. We're just tired of it. I'm tired of it. I'm tired of the blame game. I'm tired of the music never getting better. I'm tired of everybody pointing a finger at the other people. I'm tired. I literally just want the bad music to go away. So thanks for watching, everyone. Thank you to my subscribers for supporting me. Make sure to like, share, and subscribe. And I'll see you all in the next video.